Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh teman-teman semuanya. Selamat datang di Jembatan Dakwah. Dan kali ini ada Dr. Zakir naik lagi. Ini yang terbaru tahun 2023. Beliau diundang ke Nigeria untuk menyampaikan ceramahnya. Dan di sini kita bakal lihat nih, ada seseorang yang bertanya, kemudian dia berani menantang Dr. Zakir naik dan berani memberikan ayat-ayat Bible yang mengatakan bahwa Yesus adalah Tuhan. Apakah dia ingin Dr. Zakir Naik lock out secepatnya? Tapi apa jawaban dari Dr. Zakir Naik? Simak video ini selengkapnya hingga akhir agar kalian tidak salah paham. Selamat menonton dan semoga bermanfaat. Mari kita react.
So first of all, I must say, I've known you for a while. I have a Muslim sister somewhere here in the crowd, and she sends me your stuff, and I listen, and I must say it's a huge honor to be in your presence, sir. firstly, before I ask my questions, I have to lay a foundation. I have to ask you at first if you, as a Muslim, do you believe in the Bible?
Brother asked the question that do I believe in the Bible? No, I do not believe in the present Bible. I believe in the original revelation which was given to Jesus, that is the Injil. The present Bible, according to the scholars of Christianity, is not the original Injil. I believe in the original Injil, the Wahi which was given to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. According to the scholars of Christianity, there are 24,000 manuscripts of the present Bible and no two identical. So the scholars don't believe it is the word of God. How can I believe? So the present Bible is not the word of God, it is mixture. It contains some part to be the word of God, some part to the word of Jesus Christ, some part the word of historian, and some parts of pornography. Pornography. You know pornography?
I do know pornography, sir.
There is a chapter in the Bible, Ezekiel, chapter number 24, it's pornography. Even if you give me $1 million, I cannot read it. So this present Bible is a mixture. Some parts of word of God which matches with the Quran, I've got no problem agreeing it to be the word of God. Which goes against, I cannot believe. The original revelation given to Jesus was the word of God, but that hasn't been maintained. The scholars of Christianity say that, leave aside you and me, because you have not studied the Bible, you may not. Do you know that there are 24,000 manuscripts of the Bible?
I know the Bible.
And no two identical. There are so many versions of the Bible. King James Version, New International Version, American Standard Version, Revised Standard Version. In my library, I've got 250 different versions of the Bible. Quran is only one. Quran in Arabic is only one. There may be different translations, but Bible, different versions. So, the present Bible is not at all the word of God. Is it clear?
And that goes for both the Old and the New Testament.
Of course, both.
Okay. So my main question is the concept of Christ being the Son of God and the concept of Christ being God, for we as Christians, is something it's actually really easy to grasp, and for a long time I've wondered why. The concept of Christ being the Son of God and of Christ being God for us as Christians is easy to understand. It's been easy for us to grasp because we have gotten our knowledge of that concept from the Bible.
The brother saying, ask me a question, why can't the concept that Jesus is Son of God and He's God of the Bible, why can't the Muslims understand this question? So I'm telling him, I clearly mentioned in my question answer session and my talk, why can't the Muslims why can't the Christians understand? I understand the Bible very well. I'm not speaking on behalf of the other Muslims. I have read the Bible. I have studied the Bible. nowhere does the Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, and I told that there is not a single unequivocal statement, not a single unambiguous statement anywhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says, I am God, or where he says, worship me. If you brother, can point out a single verse from the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says, I am God, or where he says, worship me, I am going to accept Christianity. One verse, only one. Brother said in three places where Jesus claimed divinity. What was my challenge? There is not a single verse in the Bible where Jesus Christ himself says, I am God, or where he says, worship me. He said, Jesus said, I and my Father are one. Does it mean he's God? No. Does it mean he's God? No. My challenge was, show me a single unambiguous statement, not show me a single unequivocal statement where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says, I am God, or where he says, worship me. Brother is saying, Jesus said, I and my Father are one. Do you know where does it say in the Bible? Do you know where does it say in the Bible? No. Do you know? You don't know. Do you know the reference or not? Do you know the reference? Where does the Bible say Jesus Christ said, I and my Father are one?
I could share.
Do you know now or no? Yes or no?
I don't know now.
I'll help you.
Help me. Please.
You don't know.
Help me, please.
Okay. Yeah. What he's quoting is Gospel of John. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 30. He is telling a verse of the Bible which he believes, and I'm telling him the reference.
Thank you, sir.
You should thank me.
Thank you, sir.
So who's working hard, me or you?
Thank you, sir.
You are quoting something, I'm giving you the reference. So who's struggling more, you or me?
You.
Who's doing more research?
You.
Okay. Now what is the context? For the context of Gospel of John chapter 10 verse number 30, you have to read 7 verses before. You know the brother earlier? He tried to misguide us by quoting out of context. The brother who came before, he was trying to misguide by quoting out of context. Now I will go to the context. The context is Gospel of John chapter number 10 verse number 23. You can open the Bible and check. I'm going to speak from my mind and check whether I'm saying correct.
I have a Bible in my bag.
Okay, here it is. Help him please. Give him the Bible. I'm speaking from my memory. For the context, Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 23. It says, Jesus enters the porch in Solomon's temple. Verse number 24, the Jews, the soldiers, they surround him and ask him, How long does thou make us doubt? If thou art the Christ, tell us freely. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 23-24. Gospel of John.
Chapter 10,
verse number 30, I and my Father are one. It's too much. John is not there. John will be in the middle.
John 10.
Correct. Gospel of John, chapter 10, verse 30, correct?
100%.
Verbatim.
100%.
100%, very good. Now I will start from verse number 23. 7 verses before. Jesus enters the Solomon's porch. Read, Solomon's temple. Jesus enters the porch in Solomon's temple. Verse number 24, the Jews, the soldiers surround him and ask him, why thou make us doubt? If thou art the Christ, tell us plainly. Correct? Verse number 25. I told you, but you believe not. The work that I do in my Father's name, there bear witness of me. Verse number 26. You do not believe me because you are not my sheep. Verse number 27. My followers, they hear me and they follow me. No man can pluck them out of my hand. Verse number 29. My Father will be greater than all. No man can pluck them out of my Father's hand. Verse number 28. No man can pluck them out of my hand. Verse number 29. My Father is greater than all. No man can pluck them out of my Father's hand. Verse number 30. I and my Father are one. Here it's talking about one in purpose, not one as joined. That means Jesus Christ was talking about the truth. When he's speaking about the truth, the message was the same. If I, my Father is a doctor, I am a doctor, I and my Father are one, does it mean we're joined? No. In profession we are one. He's a doctor, I'm a doctor. He's a human being, I he. It doesn't mean I and my Father are one. You understand? My Father is a doctor, I and my Father are one. See the context. No man can pluck them out of my hand. Context. Verse number 28. No man can pluck them out of my hand. Verse number 29. No man can pluck them out of my Father's hand. I and my Father are one. If you say this one means actually one, for argument, Gospel of John chapter number 17, verse number 21 says, Jesus says, my Father is in me, I and you. I am in you, telling the 12 apostles. If you believe it's one, there should be 14 gods. Jesus, you open Gospel of John, chapter number 17, verse 23, says, Jesus says, my Father is in me, I in you. He's telling the 12 apostles that I am in you. So there should be 14 gods, why 3 gods? So this one doesn't mean one as an entity. It means one in purpose. So God was the same purpose. What Jesus Christ taught was the same purpose. What did the apostles follow the same purpose? There should be actually 14 gods. From this we come to know it doesn't mean one entity, it means one in purpose. Verse number 31, I'm continuing. Verse number 31. The Jews, they pick up stones to stone Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Verse number 32. Same, Gospel of John, chapter number 10. Verse number 32. Many of the good works have I done, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Which of the good works do you want to stone me? Verse number 33. We stone you because you, being a man, you blaspheme. The Jews are telling, we want to stone you because you, being a man, you want to blaspheme. That means even they misunderstand that he claimed his God. Correct? Like how you misunderstand. Verse number 34 is the clarification. It is said in your scripture that if the word comes through the person of God, he is called God. Chapter Psalms, chapter 82, verse number 6. 82nd Psalm, verse number 6. Ye are gods. So if the word of God comes to a person, and if you call him God, the scripture is not broken. That means small g, small God, means the messenger of God. No problem. Read the verse. Where does it say one? If you really mean I and my Father are one, then you have to say I, Father, and 12 apostles are one. All the apostles are God. Even Thomas, even Peter. Do you believe Thomas is God? Thomas is God. Thomas is God. Because Jesus said, I, Father is in me, I in you, to the apostles. We are one. If I and my Father are one is God, there should be 14 gods. I never heard any church, any Christian in my life saying there are 14 gods. That means this one is one in purpose. I answered your first question. Now second one.
Sir,
please don't give a speech.
I know. I'm
giving you a reference. Just listen to my answer.
I completely agree with all you said.
I can't hear you. That microphone you cannot hear. This you can hear.
I should use that.
That microphone you cannot hear. Different microphone.
Brothers, the first, can you hear me?
I cannot hear you. What do you want to say? The second reference he gave, second place he said, I am the way, the truth and the life. no man cometh unto the Father but through me. That you said, correct?
Sorry?
He that has seen me has seen the Father.
Sorry?
He that has seen me has seen the Father.
Yeah, that's right.
Do you know the reference? Reference?
Yeah.
What is the reference?
Sorry?
Reference.
You tell me, sir. You tell me.
Doesn't know the reference. He's telling me the verse where Jesus is God, according to him, doesn't know the reference.
But it's
Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 7. Open.
Chapter what?
Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 7.
John 14, verse 7.
By here. I'm here.
Does it say that or not?
7, 8, 9. Yeah.
Ah, good. What is the context? Context. Context is, go to verse number 1. Verse number 1. Mm-hmm. Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 1. If you believe in my Father, believe in me also. In my, verse number 2. In my Father's mansion, there are many. Oh. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. I go and then you will follow. Then Thomas says, you don't know where I go. Then he says, I am the way, the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but through me. Verse number 6. Yeah. This is one of the ways the Christian missionary says, Jesus claimed divinity. You didn't say? Others say, I am the way, the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but through me. Every messenger at this time was the way, the truth and the life. No man come unto the Father through Almighty God but through the messenger. At the time of Moses, he was the way, the truth and the life. No man came unto God but through the teachings of Moses. At the time of Jesus, he was the way, the truth and the life. No man come unto God but through the teachings of Jesus. That doesn't mean he becomes God. At the time of Prophet Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad is the way, the truth and the life. No man come unto the Father but through Prophet Muhammad. Again, he says, from now onwards, you know me and you know him. Verse number 7.
Yeah.
From today, you know me and you know him. God. Now, you know him and you have seen him. Correct?
Correct.
Now, you know him and you see him. That means, according to the Bible, knowing means seeing. So, and then he says, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. In context, knowing means seeing. So if you know me, you know the Father. If you see me, you have seen the Father. Same thing, if you know Moses, you know the Father. If you see Moses, you have seen God. If you know Prophet Muhammad, you know God. If you see Prophet Muhammad, you have seen God in context. It doesn't make them God. The third difference. Jesus said, I am Alpha and Omega. No beginning, no end. Doesn't the Bible say that Jesus was born in the stable? In Bethlehem? He had a beginning. It's a contradiction. Right or wrong? Jesus is Alpha and Omega. No beginning, no end. He had a beginning in the stable. Right or wrong?
Right.
That means it's false. The Bible is telling the wrong thing. He is not the beginning, the no beginning and no end. That's the reason I'm telling you, study the Bible. You study the Bible, hear my videos, you'll come to the truth.
Dan begitulah jawaban-jawaban dari Dr. Zakir Naik. Ya, memang beliau ini sangat luar biasa, teman-teman. Kalau teman-teman tahu beliau, bagaimana beliau itu menyampaikan pendapatnya, bagaimana beliau itu belajar, dan bagaimana beliau itu mengajar scholar muslim. Scholar muslim itu apa? Pendakwah-pendakwah muslim. Admin sebenarnya pernah nontonin muridnya Dr. Zakir Naik ini. Jadi waktu itu kalau teman-teman pengen tahu bagaimana cara Dr. Zakir Naik untuk menggembleng orang-orang yang ingin belajar dengan beliau itu, jadi dari pagi sampai jam 3 malam sampai subuh itu mereka harus terus belajar. Itu sangat luar biasa sekali. Kalau kalian pengen dengar cerita lengkapnya, kalian bisa lihat di YouTube-nya ceritanya Firdaus Wong dari Malaysia itu. dia belajar bagaimana benar-benar Dr. Zakir Naik ini benar-benar menggembleng dari pagi sampai subuh selama 30 hari. Bahkan ada itu orang dari luar tuh sampai apa ya? Sampai dia tuh baru 3 hari itu udah enggak kuat, udah nyerah dia. Soalnya enggak bisa tidur nyenyak, enggak bisa tidur apa namanya? Tidur dengan pokoknya itu tidurnya cuman paling 3 jam, 4 jam, habis itu belajar lagi, dihajar dengan ilmu lagi, dihabisi dengan pertanyaan-pertanyaan ini. Kamu harus bisa menjawabnya. Dan harus yang pertama adalah harus paham Quran dulu, teman-teman. Itu yang sangat luar biasa gemblengan dari Dr. Zakir Naik ini yang bikin enggak semua orang bisa untuk mengikuti jejak beliau. Firdaus Wong, teman-teman, cari aja ceritanya di situ. Dan luar biasanya adalah Dr. Zakir Naik ini mampu untuk memberikan jawaban-jawaban yang bagi kita itu sangat cerdas ya, teman-teman. Sangat cerdas sekali karena kita tahu sendiri bahwa beliau itu menguasai Quran, tafsir, kemudian paham Bible, apal Bible dari beberapa versi. Kemudian yang jarang diketahui dan jarang didapatkan yang jarang orang itu bisa itu dia juga tahu Vedas ya, karena dia adalah berasal dari Hindustan, dari India, jadi dia juga paham Vedas itu yang sangat luar biasa dan jarang sekali orang yang paham itu. Walaupun kita paham bahwa di luar sana, di western sana, banyak orang-orang seperti Muhammad Ali, Syekh Uthman, yang ada di Speaker's Corner itu memang sangat luar biasa, tapi jarang sekali orang yang bisa paham terkait agama yang mempunyai kitab suci Vedas itu. Dan beliau sangat luar biasa. Semoga dia selalu diberkahi Allah, dilindungi Allah Subhanahu wa taala dan terus mendakwahkan Islam sebagai agama yang rahmatan lil alamin. Amin. Terima kasih teman-teman telah menonton video ini hingga akhir. Sampai jumpa pada video dakwah berikutnya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.